अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर कोर्स विद द टॉपिक लिमिट्स एंड वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद एक्सरसाइज 1.1। मैनी आइडियाज़ ऑफ कैलकुलस ओरिजिनेटेड विद द फॉलोइंग प्रॉब्लम्स। नंबर वन इज अ टेंजेंट लाइन प्रॉब्लम इन विच वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द इक्वेशन ऑफ अ टेंजेंट लाइन टू अ गिवन कर्व एट सम पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट। एंड द नंबर टू इज द एरिया प्रॉब्लम इन विच वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द एरिया अंडर द कर्व विच इज़ नॉर्मली रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द इंटीग्रेशन और द इंटीग्रल ऑफ द कर्व। सो द पोर्शन ऑफ कैलकुलस अराइजिंग फ्रॉम द सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम इज कॉल्ड द डिफरेंशियल कैलकुलस एंड दैट अराइजिंग फ्रॉम द सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम इज कॉल्ड द इंटीग्रल कैलकुलस। Next we have tangent line and limit, that how the tangent line is related to the limit or how tangent line helps to define the limit. We know that tangent line is a line that touch the graph exactly at one point. So you can see that at point P this will be a tangent line, at point Q this will be a tangent line, because tangent line is a line that touch the graph exactly at one point, do not cross the graph, it just touch the graph. So you can see that at every point we are having a different tangent line. So let's suppose we are having a graph of the function y is equal to f of x to be this one, and we are having two points P and Q on this curve, and we are having a line passing through the points which is basically named as the secant line. So you can see that this one is not a tangent line right now because it is crossing the graph at two points. Now this secant line will be a tangent line if I am taking Q very very close to P, that is Q approaches to P. Q approaches to P means Q is very 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 close to P but not exactly equal to P. For example, if I take Q over here, this will be my line which is very close to the tangent line. Now if I take Q to be here, this will be more closer and closer to the tangent line. So as Q approaches to P, the secant line will approaches to be the tangent line. So this is the beauty of limit, that we take the values very very close to some particular point but not exactly equal to that particular point. So limit stands for approaching value or the approximate value that is very very close to a point but not exactly equal to that point. For example, we have to find out the equation of tangent line to the parabola y is equal to x square at the point P11. So you can see that we have to find out the equation of a tangent line in which the function is given, which is y is equal to x square, and the point is given to be 11. Now we know that whenever we have to find out the equation of a line, we may use the point slope form, and which is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. That is, we must know what is the slope of the line. So in order to find out the slope of tangent line, we must know the two points on the tangent line, and now we know that we can find only one point on the tangent line, or we can find out only one point related to the curve on the tangent point. So at first we will find out the slope of the secant line, and the formula of the slope is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Here is the formula for the slope of any line, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So let's suppose we are having a secant line over here in which we are having a point P and a point Q, and the coordinates of the point Q are x and y. Now it is given to us that y is equal to x square, so the point is going to be x and x square. So the slope of secant line is going to be y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, that is x plus 1. On simplifying, we get x plus 1 over here. Now we have discussed that as Q approaches to P, the secant line will approaches to be the tangent line, that is limit x approaches to 1. This is the notation of limit, that x is getting closer and closer to 1 because the x coordinate of Q is x and the x coordinate of P is 1. So it means if I take the values of x very very close to 1, this is going to be a tangent line. So applying limit x approaches to 1, this is going to be 1 plus 1 2, that is the slope of tangent line is 2 now, and inserting the values in point slope form, which is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, we get the equation of tangent line, which is 2x minus 1. Here is the tangent line over here. Let's suppose we are having a function f of x is equal to x square minus x plus 1, and here is the graph of this function. Let's suppose we are up, x is approaching to 2, or we want to approximate its value at point 2. So we are approaching to 2 means we are getting closer and closer to 2 as shown over here. So what is the method to find out the limit? Mathematically, we just need to put the values in the place of x, or how we can find out it graphically as well. So you can see that as we are approaching to 2, that is the graph is getting closer and closer to 2 over here. The graph is getting the value 3 as shown, or the value of y is getting closer and closer to 3. As x is approaches to 2 from right hand side means we are taking the values greater than 2 and we are going very, very close to 2. So here when we are approaching to 2 from right hand side, the graph is also approaching to 3. So this is how we can find out the graph, or we can find out the limit of some function with the help of graph. So here is the formal definition of a limit, that if the values of f of x can be made as close we like to L by taking the values of x sufficiently close to A, that is very, very close to A but not equal to A, then we write limit x approaches to A f of x is equal to L. Here we have another example to describe mathematically what is the meaning of limit to us. For example, we are having a function f of x is equal to x square minus 4 over x minus 2, as we have discussed in 101 or pre-calculus, that its domain will be equal to set of all real numbers except 2, because at x is equal to 2 the denominator is getting 0, so we have to take out 2 from the domain. It means we cannot find out the functional value at x is equal to 2, or we cannot put x is equal to 2 in our function. So how now we will check that is it possible to find out the limiting value at x is equal to 2 or not. So we will simplify the function first. It is going to be x plus 2. Now we are going to put the values approaching to 2 from left hand side. From left hand side means we are taking the values less than 2. So we are starting with 1, 1.5, 1.9, 1.99, and the function you can see getting closer and closer to 4. It means when x approaches to 2 from left hand side, the answer will be 4. Now similarly, if I take approaching values from the right hand side of 2, that is the greater values of 2, so 3, then 2.7, 2.2, 2.01, 2.0001, very, very close to 2 but not equal to 2, and you can see that the values are getting closer and closer to 4. That's why we are saying that limit x approaches to 2 f of x is equal to 4. So you can see that this is the beauty of limit, that either we are possible to find out the value at some particular point or not, we can always find out the limiting value of a function at any point. Here is the graph of the function. You can see that there is a hole at point 2 because the point is not included in the domain, but we are able to find out its limiting value, or the limiting behavior, which is approaching to 4. We can check it graphically as well. As we are approaching to 2 from left hand side, the graph is getting values closer and closer to 4, and exactly from right hand side it also approaching to 4. Next we have the one-sided limits. As we have discussed that we are approaching to some particular number from left hand side or from right hand side, these are named as a one-sided limit. Left hand side means we are taking the values less than 2 or less than A, and greater than A means, or the right hand side of A means, we are taking the values greater than A. For example, we are having a piecewise defined function f of x is equal to mod of x over x, which is equal to 1 for x greater than 0 and minus 1 for x less than 0. You can see that x is equal to 0 is not a part of the domain because it is going to make our denominator 0. So when approaching to 0 from left hand side, this little representation, or this negative sign, is representing to be the left hand side, and this positive sign is representing that we are approaching 0 from right hand side. It is not playing the role that 0 is negative or positive. This negative or positive are just representing that we are approaching to a particular number from left hand side or from right hand side. So negative stands for the left hand side and positive stands for the right hand side. So when we are approaching to 0 from left hand side, you can see that the values are getting closer and closer to minus 1. Left hand side means less than 0, so it will be equal to minus 1. For right hand side, that is greater than 0, it will be equal to plus 1. Now you can see that from left hand side and the right hand side are getting two different values. So it means that the two-sided limit will not exist in this case, because when we approach 0 from left hand side, there is some other number. From right hand side, we are getting some other number. So you can see that there is a jump or a gap over here. So it means that the two-sided limit does not exist. So this is how we can say that when the two-sided limit exists, when the one-sided limits are exist and equal to, then we will say that the two-sided limit exists. So here you can see that whenever the one-sided limit exists and equal, that is limit x approaches to a from left-hand side is equal to L, also limit x approaches to a from right-hand side is equal to L, then we will say that the two-sided limit exists and it is equal to L. Here we have question number 2 from exercise 1.1 for the function g graphed in the given figure. Here is the figure. We have to find out limit x approaches to 0 from left hand side. So you can see that when approaches to 0 from left hand side, the function is getting closer and closer to 0. So it's 0. For limit x approaches to 0 from right hand side, we are taking these values are getting for x, and we have to take or find out the values for y. So when approaches to 0 from right hand side, you can see that the graph is getting closer and closer to 0. So from right hand side, it is also equal to 0. So because the one sided limits exist and both are same, that's why the two sided limit exist and it will be equal to 0 as well. Now we have g of 0, that is functional value of 0, it will be equal to 0 as well. Next we have question number 4. Again we have to find out the limit x approaches to 2 from left hand side. So you can see that from left hand side the graph is getting closer and closer to 2. So from left hand x approaches to 2 from left hand side it is equal to 2, and for right hand side here is the 2 and here we are getting closer and closer to 2 from right hand side, and in this portion the graph is getting closer and closer to 0. So this is 0 because that one sided limits are not the same. It means the two sided limit does not exist in this case, and functional value is equal to 2 because we are having a dot at 2. Next we have infinite limits. It means that we may have infinity as an answer of a limit. It is not necessary that we always have some finite number. We may have positive infinity or negative infinity depending upon the function, that whenever we are having a zero in the denominator, it will approach to infinity. For example, when we have to find out the limit x approaches to a from right hand side for the expression 1 over x minus a. Now because x is approaching to a from right hand side, it means x will be greater than a and it will be a positive answer. So it is going to be positive infinity because 1 by 0 is going to be infinity, and because of positive expressions we will have positive infinity. But when we are approaching a from the left hand side, you can see that left hand side means x is less than a. So this expression is going to have negative values. Negative values very, very close to 0. That's why we are going to have negative infinity in this case. So as far as the graph is concerned, here is the graph of 1 over x minus a. You can see that when we are approaching to x, we are approaching to a from the left hand side, it is getting closer and closer to negative infinity, and for right hand side it is getting value to be positive infinity. Next we have the expression 1 over x minus a whole square. So either we are approaching to a from right hand side or from left hand side, this square will make the answer to be positive. That's why we will have positive infinity in both cases, and that's why the two sided limit exists and it will be equal to the positive infinity as well. So it always depends on the function that how we are getting the values. For example, for x approaches to a from right hand side, minus 1 over x minus a. Now for right hand side, x is greater than a, that is x minus a will be positive, but this negative will make the answer to be negative. That's why we are having negative infinity in this case. So here is the graph for 1 over x minus a whole square. You can see that either approaching to a from left hand side or from right hand side, the answer will be equal to infinity. For minus 1 over x minus a, when we approach to a from left hand side, it will be positive infinity. For right hand side, it will be negative infinity. For minus 1 over x minus a whole square, it will always approach to negative infinity.